Unless you've been avoiding the internet for a decade, and if so, welcome, you've probably heard about the bee rapture. In 2006, the first instances of something called colony collapse disorder were reported. That winter, 25% of all bee colonies in the US were destroyed. That means billions of bees. CCD is this strange phenomenon where worker bees leave the colony never to return. The queen, bee youngins, and all that honey is just left behind. CCD could devastate food production as bee pollination accounts for $15 billion a year in crops. But no bees, no foods. So for at least a decade, scientists have been working like bees to try and solve CCD. They found at least 60 different environmental factors, like a combination of invasive pests, climate change, and pesticide poisoning. After all this research, a new report has finally given us some good news. The bees are making a comeback. The USDA just released its latest honeybee health survey, and the number of honeybees is on the rise. There are now 2.89 million honeybee colonies, a 3% increase from the previous year, and the number of hives lost to colony collapse disorder is down 27% from the previous year. Victorious! But hold on just a second. There are still some major threats to beehives. Mainly two things, the pesky Varroa mite and pesticides. The mite, also called the Varroa destructor, don't get too excited, it's a cool name, but it's bad, is the ultimate honeybee pest. These destructors are parasites that thrive inside beehives, sucking blood from the bees while transmitting viruses directly into their bloodstream. They end up leaving the bees weakened with shorter lifespans and in some cases with deformed wings. Honeybees are part of a collective. They all work together and they need to help each other to keep the colony alive. So if a hive is mite infested to the point of no return, it will eventually collapse. By nature, the Varroa mite is not a migratory pest, which we thought was good for bee kind because they could be isolated. But now a new paper found the mite is able to hitchhike on wandering bees and spread to new hives. This is particularly problematic for commercial beekeeping where beehives are kept in close proximity because the Varroa destructors can ride on the backs of weakened honeybees to neighboring colonies and start an infestation all over. Varroa destructors were wreaking havoc in 42% of US colonies between April and June of 2017, which is down from last year's figures, but still isn't quite where we want it to be. The secondary enemy for the bee is pesticides, particularly neonicotinoids. This year, the USDA reported that pesticides were responsible for 13% of total damage to bees. Neonicotinoids, or neonics, are synthetic chemical insecticides that are very similar in molecular structure to nicotine. It's even got the word in there. When a neonic is sprayed on crops, the chemicals are absorbed in the plant's nectar and pollen. This makes the flowers toxic to the bees who swing by for lunch. Countless studies have drawn a link between neonics and neurological damage in bees. It's also reportedly affected their ability to fly home, which may explain why worker bees aren't returning to their colonies, hence the colony collapse. So here's the buzz. The bees are bouncing back, but they will need more help. If you want to help the bees and happen to be a gardener, maybe avoid using outdoor insecticides near flowers that bees might be attracted to, or nurture some plants that could be future pollination pit stops for our buzzy friends. In the end, just be aware. Bees are just the best and I love them, but they work so hard. Do they ever sleep? Julian has the answer right here about insect sleep. Are you worried about bees? Bee fatigue, if you will? Tell us in the comments. Please subscribe. And thanks for watching Bee Seeker. Thanks.